In this video, I'm going to share with you exactly how I was able to go from 0 to 10,000 subscribers on YouTube. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Lester Diaz, and in this channel, we talk about making money online, affiliate marketing, social media marketing, and everything in between. So if you're new, consider subscribing. So first of all, I want to say thank you to all of you who are watching my videos, liking my videos, commenting, and best of all, subscribing to my channel. I wouldn't be here without you, and so I want to say thank you, and I hope that you continue to support my channel, and I'll continue to provide the best type of content that I can provide, and I'll do my best to provide you with as much value as I can. So basically what I want to do in this video is break down the process of how I gained my first 1,000 subscribers and how I actually built my way to 10,000 subscribers in about 11 months. Now, I heard some people say that 10,000 subscribers is very difficult to get. But in my experience, 1,000 subscribers was actually very difficult as well. I would say it's much harder to get 1,000 subscribers than it is to get 10,000. And so I'm gonna share with you my analytics. I'm gonna show you exactly, you know, how many videos I posted. I'm gonna show you my growth over time, exactly how many subscribers I was getting. I'm gonna show you basically everything that I know so far and everything that I have learned over the past 11-12 months by posting videos, over 170 videos so far. If you're thinking about starting a YouTube channel, you can utilize some of these tips to motivate you and actually get started and actually start uploading videos and doing this because you love it, not just because you want to make money, but also because you enjoy the process of making videos and growing your audience and providing value. So about 10 months ago, I've decided to create a case study where I would document my journey from basically 1,000 subscribers to 10,000. And this past weekend, actually on my birthday, I was able to reach 10,000 subscribers on that day. So that's actually pretty special considering that it was my birthday. Now, if you wanna watch that case study way back from the beginning, about 11 months ago, I'm gonna put a link to the playlist below so you can go and watch my journey, everything that I went through and basically, you know, the things that I learned along the way. Hopefully you can utilize that as a motivation to also apply some of the tips to your channel, and you can improve your channel little by little so you can become better. But I believe 10,000 is just the beginning. I'm hoping that, you know, over the next 12 months, I'll be able to reach 50,000 subscribers. And basically it's not gonna be easy, but you know, time goes by anyways. I believe that if you're consistent with something, if you're able to put up the work and actually, you know, create the content, provide value, it is definitely possible. Now, the one thing that I learned with YouTube is that it takes time. You gotta be patient, you gotta put up the work, and sometimes, you know, you're not gonna get the views on the video that you thought you were gonna get, but you gotta keep trying. You gotta keep posting videos, you gotta keep optimizing your titles, you gotta keep coming up with new video ideas, because that's what's gonna help you grow and actually get more subscribers, get more views, and actually improve your channel. I actually started posting on this channel at the end of 2017. I would post, you know, one video a month or something like that. I actually wasn't very consistent. And then about 11-12 months ago, I decided that, you know, I was actually gonna take this seriously and start posting every single week. And so that's what I did. Every single week, I would post at least 2 to 3 videos per week. And I would rank some of those videos on the first page of YouTube. That would drive even more views, that would help me get more subscribers. I was actually constantly engaged with other YouTube channels in the same niche, and I would actually post a lot of comments. I would engage 24/7 in many of those videos, and that would also help me drive a lot of traffic back to my YouTube channel. And in fact, if you go and watch this video, I explain in detail how I was able to get up to 1,000 subscribers in the first 60 days by using this exact same strategy, by basically engaging with other YouTube channels in the same niche. It doesn't matter what type of channel you have, you can probably find 20 to 25 channels in your niche which you can use to drive traffic back to your YouTube channel. But you gotta be smart on the way that you do it. You can't just spam every single YouTube video that you can find thinking that people will subscribe if you simply ask them to subscribe. It doesn't work like that. What you have to do is provide value, be smart with your comments, and know exactly what makes people click to go visit your YouTube channel. Now, I'm not sure if I wanna keep doing this type of series of, you know, documenting my journey to from 10,000 to 100,000 subscribers. I'm not sure if I want to do that. I'm still thinking about it. So if you guys want me to do that, let me know in the comment section below. Let me know if you want me to do the same exact thing and try to document my journey from 10,000 to 100,000 subscribers and see, you know, how we actually go along that journey so we can learn together. But with that said, what I'm gonna do is jump into my computer and actually break down the analytics. All right, you guys, so we're inside my YouTube analytics page. And what I've done is I selected the last 365 days to show you guys that the past 12 months have generated 9,000 subscribers, 9,700 subscribers to my channel. And basically this all happened in the last 12 months. And that's where I made the decision that I was gonna do this and I was gonna be consistent. And I would, you know, upload videos every single week and hopefully, you know, provide value. And if you're thinking, well, I need a lot of subscribers to be able to get some views, not necessarily. Let me show you something. This is really interesting because over the past 365 days, most of the watch time that came in were not from people who were subscribed to my YouTube channel. So most of the views that I'm getting today are not from people who are subscribed to my YouTube channel, are basically from, you know, YouTube just recommending my content or being found on the YouTube search results. You need to focus on creating valuable content that is being found on YouTube, and that's going to drive the views, and as a result you will get more subscribers. These are the first videos that I started experimenting with, you know, what I wanted to do with this YouTube channel. I just wanted to share my content. I just wanted to, you know, see if I could create a personal brand and actually, you know, provide some of the knowledge that I have gained over the past few years and put it on multiple YouTube videos. And at the same time, see if I could rank on YouTube, see if I could put some of these techniques to the test. And as a result, you can see some of the videos were some of the worst videos in the beginning, but I actually started getting better. I started creating different thumbnails and I started experimenting with, you know, different designs to see what would work and what didn't work. Don't be discouraged if you put out a video that only gets 100 views. You get the opportunity to try again. You get the chance to keep posting more content and try as many times as you can. I learned that creating thumbnails was one of the biggest things that you can learn how to do, because that's the first thing that people see. That's the first impression of your video. If you don't have a good thumbnail, people will not click on your video. And some videos that I thought would actually go viral didn't go viral. I didn't get as many views, but I kept trying. Like for example, if we go down, you can see this video right here, how I made, you know, $1,234 with Facebook. This video took off and I actually had no clue that that video would get that many views, but it did took off. It had 42,000 views in 9 months. But I kept uploading videos and uploading videos, and as you can see, many different thumbnails, testing different things, and so far I have 177 videos. So it took me about 12 months and 177 videos to get to 10,000 subscribers, and as you can see, total views, 623,000 views. So if we go to my Social Blade stats, you can see my growth over time and the total subs here. You can see August 2018, and we are in August right now. I only had 350 subscribers at that time, and it just kept going up little by little, you know, started posting content. And it's a very slow process, but trust me, once you get the ball rolling, once you start uploading videos every single week, it's gonna get easier. And just be consistent and just try to engage with other YouTubers out there in the comment section of other videos, and just provide value. Don't just spam and thinking that people will subscribe to your YouTube channel automatically just because you're telling them to subscribe. And just don't do the sub for sub thing that I see in a lot of comment section, thinking that, hey guys, subscribe to my YouTube channel and I'll subscribe to yours. Most of the people who are doing that, they have no interest in watching your YouTube videos. You want to get real people, real subscribers who are going to engage with your videos and actually subscribe and actually, you know, like your content and leave you a comment. And those are the people that you really want. So what I want to do is show you my videos so far. I want to show you my most popular videos, and I'm going to sort this by views because I want to show you, you know, the videos that I've gotten the most views so far. You can see 120,000 views. This is my most popular video. That's because this video is ranking for many different keywords related to making money with Facebook. And then you can see the different type of videos that I've received over 10,000 views. Notice one thing, guys. I've seen some other YouTube channels out there who had one video that just blew up and received, you know, a million views in a month, and they just blew up in terms of subscribers because they had 15,000, 20,000 subscribers in a single month because of one video that YouTube recommended. That actually hasn't happened to me in the past 12 months. It's been consistent work every single week putting out new videos. So hopefully this is a lesson to you if you're thinking that, you know, you gotta have a viral hit if you actually wanna make it on YouTube. No, just be consistent with your content. Don't be discouraged by the numbers. Just put out new videos every single week, as long as it takes. If it takes you 12 months to get 1,000 subscribers, it will take you 3 months to get the next 1,000. And give it your best shot. And if you're not able to do it, just try again and try again and try again. As you can see, we have grown a lot in the past 10 months. I've been posting videos consistently, and basically I've been focusing more on creating content that people are searching for on YouTube. At the same time, I've studied other YouTube channels and I figure out what are the videos that are actually being recommended the most, what are the videos that are getting a lot of views, and I've tried to, you know, replicate some of those videos. Some of the videos were successful. I've gotten some views on some of those videos. Other videos were a complete flop, and that's okay because you learn from those videos. Not every single video that you upload is gonna go viral, and that's okay. The good thing about this is that you get the opportunity to try again. You can continue to try again. You can upload new videos every single week, and you know, you never know if a video is gonna go viral. You never know if a video is gonna, you know, hit a million views in a week, or if that video flops, well, at least you tried it, and at least you can say that, hey, let me just try this new idea and see if that video takes off and helps me get even more subscribers. And actually improving your channel, improving your videos little by little, even if you don't have a lot of money to invest into, you know, any gear, you can improve your videos by, you know, improving your editing. You can see the difference on the way that I'm editing the videos right now to where I was doing it, you know, 10, 12 months ago, and I'm still learning how to do it. I'm brand new to this YouTube thing, and basically what I'm trying to do is get better as much as I can every single month. And so with that said, guys, I want to say thank you once again for subscribing to my channel. If you're watching this video for the first time, if you don't know who I am, I would encourage you to check out my YouTube channel. I have a bunch of videos that can teach you how to do online marketing, affiliate marketing, how you can build a business online, how you can learn how to grow a YouTube channel, how to actually make money with Facebook, how to grow a Facebook page. I have a bunch of videos that can teach you how to go from basically nothing to making a full-time income online. And let me know if you want to see videos like this. Let me know if you want me to document my journey to 100,000 subscribers. And I'll be glad to do it, to show you guys that it is possible if you actually put your mind to it and actually are consistent with your content. With that said, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope that you liked this video. If you did, hit the like button, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't subscribed already, and I hope to see you in my next video.